Intersex and proud, model Han Gabby Odile on finally celebrating her body. Like many models, Han Gabby Odile has a lovely limber angularity. Sitting in a Manhattan restaurant booth, she seems to open and close like an umbrella, expanding when she's in full flow, folding up when she's mulling something over. Folded up and closed off was how she felt for a long time. As a child, she knew something was different about her. She spent a lot of her summers undergoing surgery, and was aware that she would be unable to have children, but the why was always left vague. "The medical world tells us that we should not talk to anyone about it," she says. "Always, I was told to hide." In this way, children like Odile are taught to be ashamed of a fundamental aspect of their identity: they are intersex. It's difficult to calculate the exact number of people who are intersex, but Interact Advocates for Intersex Youth estimates it to be about 1.7%, which is about as common as having red hair, 1%, 2%. It took a long time for Odile, now 28, to come out of hiding, but in January she came out publicly in Vogue, and instantly brought into focus the sixth and least appreciated letter in the queer acronym, LGBTQI. "For a lot of people, the first time they hear about it is when they talk to me," Odile says. "Most people really have no idea." Dressed in Adidas jogging bottoms and clutching a bottle of orange soda, she talks rapidly, as if she might have to dart off as quickly as she arrived. Her eyes are bright and animated. "There's a kind of shame placed on our bodies, like we're not supposed to talk about it," she says. "I will never know what it is to be a cisgender woman, I will never be able to talk about a period or having a child, but I'm not a man either, I'm proud intersex. I always felt I was the only one like me, that I had this weird thing going on having grown up in a Belgian village in the pre-dawn of social M." Intersex and proud, model Han Gabby Odile on finally celebrating her body. Like many models, Han Gabby Odile has a lovely limber angularity. Sitting in a Manhattan restaurant booth, she seems to open and close like an umbrella, expanding when she's in full flow, folding up when she's mulling something over. Folded up and closed off was how she felt for a long time. As a child, she knew something was different about her. She spent a lot of her summers undergoing surgery, and was aware that she would be unable to have children, but the why was always left vague. "The medical world tells us that we should not talk to anyone about it," she says. "Always, I was told to hide." In this way, children like Odile are taught to be ashamed of a fundamental aspect of their identity: they are intersex. It's difficult to calculate the exact number of people who are intersex, but Interact Advocates for Intersex Youth estimates it to be about 1.7%, which is about as common as having red hair, 1%, 2%. It took a long time for Odile, now 28, to come out of hiding, but in January she came out publicly in Vogue, and instantly brought into focus the sixth and least appreciated letter in the queer acronym, LGBTQI. "For a lot of people, the first time they hear about it is when they talk to me," Odile says. "Most people really have no idea." Dressed in Adidas jogging bottoms and clutching a bottle of orange soda, she talks rapidly, as if she might have to dart off as quickly as she arrived. Her eyes are bright and animated. "There's a kind of shame placed on our bodies, like we're not supposed to talk about it," she says. "I will never know what it is to be a cisgender woman, I will never be able to talk about a period or having a child, but I'm not a man either, I'm proud intersex. I always felt I was the only one like me, that I had this weird thing going on having grown up in a Belgian village in the pre-dawn of social M." Intersex and proud, model Han Gabby Odile on finally celebrating her body. Like many models, Han Gabby Odile has a lovely limber angularity. Sitting in a Manhattan restaurant booth, she seems to open and close like an umbrella, expanding when she's in full flow, folding up when she's mulling something over. Folded up and closed off was how she felt for a long time. As a child, she knew something was different about her. She spent a lot of her summers undergoing surgery, and was aware that she would be unable to have children, but the why was always left vague. "The medical world tells us that we should not talk to anyone about it," she says. "Always, I was told to hide." In this way, Children like Odile are taught to be ashamed of a fundamental aspect of their identity, they are intersex. It's difficult to calculate the exact number of people who are intersex, but Interact Advocates for Intersex Youth estimates it to be about 1.7%, which is about as common as having red hair, 1%, 2%. It took a long time for Odile, now 28, to come out of hiding, but in January she came out publicly in Vogue, and instantly brought into focus the sixth and least appreciated letter in the queer acronym, LGBTQI. For a lot of people, the first time they hear about it is when they talk to me, Odile says. Most people really have no idea. Dressed in Adidas jogging bottoms and clutching a bottle of orange soda, she talks rapidly, as if she might have to dart off as quickly as she arrived. Her eyes are bright and animated. There's a kind of shame placed on our bodies, like we're not supposed to talk about it, she says. I will never know what it is to be a cisgender woman, I will never be able to talk about a period or having a child, but I'm not a man either, I'm proud intersex. I always felt I was the only one like me, that I had this weird thing going on having grown up in a Belgian village in the pre-dawn of social M. Intersex and proud, model Han Gabby Odile on finally celebrating her body. Like many models, Han Gabby Odile has a lovely limber angularity. Sitting in a Manhattan restaurant booth, she seems to open and close like an umbrella, expanding when she's in full flow, folding up when she's mulling something over. Folded up and closed off was how she felt for a long time. As a child, she knew something was different about her. She spent a lot of her summers undergoing surgery, and was aware that she would be unable to have children, but the why was always left vague. The medical world tells us that we should not talk to anyone about it, she says. Always, I was told to hide. In this way, children like Odile are taught to be ashamed of a fundamental aspect of their identity, they are intersex. It's difficult to calculate the exact number of people who are intersex, but Interact Advocates for Intersex Youth estimates it to be about 1.7%, which is about as common as having red hair, 1%, 2%. It took a long time for Odile, now 28, to come out of hiding, but in January she came out publicly in Vogue, and instantly brought into focus the sixth and least appreciated letter in the queer acronym, LGBTQI. For a lot of people, the first time they hear about it is when they talk to me, Odile says. Most people really have no idea. Dressed in Adidas jogging bottoms and clutching a bottle of orange soda, she talks rapidly, as if she might have to dart off as quickly as she arrived. Her eyes are bright and animated. There's a kind of shame placed on our bodies, like we're not supposed to talk about it, she says. I will never know what it is to be a cisgender woman, I will never be able to talk about a period or having a child, but I'm not a man either, I'm proud intersex. I always felt I was the only one like me, that I had this weird thing going on having grown up in a Belgian village in the pre-dawn of social M. Intersex and proud, model Han Gabby Odile on finally celebrating her body. Like many models, Han Gabby Odile has a lovely limber angularity. Sitting in a Manhattan restaurant booth, she seems to open and close like an umbrella, expanding when she's in full flow, folding up when she's mulling something over. Folded up and closed off was how she felt for a long time. As a child, she knew something was different about her. She spent a lot of her summers undergoing surgery, and was aware that she would be unable to have children, but the why was always left vague. The medical world tells us that we should not talk to anyone about it, she says. Always, I was told to hide. In this way, children like Odile are taught to be ashamed of a fundamental aspect of their identity, they are intersex. It's difficult to calculate the exact number of people who are intersex, but Interact Advocates for Intersex Youth estimates it to be about 1.7%, which is about as common as having red hair, 1%, 2%. It took a long time for Odile, now 28, to come out of hiding, but in January she came out publicly in Vogue, and instantly brought into focus the sixth and least appreciated letter in the queer acronym, LGBTQI. For a lot of people, the first time they hear about it is when they talk to me, Odile says. Most people really have no idea. Dressed in Adidas jogging bottoms and clutching a bottle of orange soda, she talks rapidly, as if she might have to dart off as quickly as she arrived. Her eyes are bright and animated. There's a kind of shame placed on our bodies, like we're not supposed to talk about it, she says. I will never know what it is to be a cisgender woman, I will never be able to talk about a period or having a child, but I'm not a man either, I'm proud intersex. I always felt I was the only one like me, that I had this weird thing going on having grown up in a Belgian village in the pre-dawn of social M. Intersex and proud, model Han Gabby Odiel on finally celebrating her body. Like many models, Han Gabby Odiel has a lovely limber angularity. Sitting in a Manhattan restaurant booth, she seems to open and close like an umbrella, expanding when she's in full flow, folding up when she's mulling something over. Folded up and closed off was how she felt for a long time. As a child, she knew something was different about her. She spent a lot of her summers undergoing surgery, and was aware that she would be unable to have children, but the why was always left vague. The medical world tells us that we should not talk to anyone about it, she says. Always, I was told to hide. In this way, children like Odiel are taught to be ashamed of a fundamental aspect of their identity, they are intersex. It's difficult to calculate the exact number of people who are intersex, but Interact Advocates for Intersex Youth estimates it to be about 1.7%, which is about as common as having red hair, 1%, 2%. It took a long time for Odiel, now 28, to come out of hiding, but in January she came out publicly in Vogue, and instantly brought into focus the sixth and least appreciated letter in the queer acronym, LGBTQI. For a lot of people, the first time they hear about it is when they talk to me, Odiel says. Most people really have no idea. Dressed in Adidas jogging bottoms and clutching a bottle of orange soda, she talks rapidly, as if she might have to dart off as quickly as she arrived. Her eyes are bright and animated. There's a kind of shame placed on our bodies, like we're not supposed to talk about it, she says. I will never know what it is to be a cisgender woman, I will never be able to talk about a period or having a child, but I'm not a man either, I'm proud intersex. I always felt I was the only one like me, that I had this weird thing going on having grown up in a Belgian village in the pre-dawn of social M. Intersex and proud, model Han Gabby Odiel on finally celebrating her body. Like many models, Han Gabby Odiel has a lovely limber angularity. Sitting in a Manhattan restaurant booth, she seems to open and close like an umbrella, expanding when she's in full flow, folding up when she's mulling something over. Folded up and closed off was how she felt for a long time. As a child, she knew something was different about her. She spent a lot of her summers undergoing surgery, and was aware that she would be unable to have children, but the why was always left vague. The medical world tells us that we should not talk to anyone about it, she says. Always, I was told to hide. In this way, children like Odiel are taught to be ashamed of a fundamental aspect of their identity, they are intersex. It's difficult to calculate the exact number of people who are intersex, but Interact Advocates for Intersex Youth estimates it to be about 1.7%, which is about as common as having red hair, 1%, 2%. It took a long time for Odiel, now 28, to come out of hiding, but in January she came out publicly in Vogue, and instantly brought into focus the sixth and least appreciated letter in the queer acronym, LGBTQI. For a lot of people, the first time they hear about it is when they talk to me, Odiel says. Most people really have no idea. Dressed in Adidas jogging bottoms and clutching a bottle of orange soda, she talks rapidly, as if she might have to dart off as quickly as she arrived. Her eyes are bright and animated. There's a kind of shame placed on our bodies, like we're not supposed to talk about it, she says. I will never know what it is to be a cisgender woman, I will never be able to talk about a period or having a child, but I'm not a man either, I'm proud intersex. I always felt I was the only one like me, that I had this weird thing going on having grown up in a Belgian village in the pre-dawn of social M.